You know, I wanted to tell a story about the death of the family business and the sort of rise of corporate America and this conflict between the Gerhardt family now facing this Kansas City organization, which is more corporate.
That's pretty interesting to watch a very well-resourced organization take on a smaller time one.
The Gerhardts really represent the dying age of family business, whether it's a crime business or it's a mom and pop bakery. Just happens to be a crime family.
This is our business. We built it with blood and muscle. It's earned. And you can't just write a check.
We're talking about the Kansas City Mafia. They're like all the sharks in the sea. And we're, let's be honest, we're small time.
You're seeing it through that prism of blood, and that's the hurdle you have to jump when you go into business with someone you care about.
I think that family means different things for each member. And I think for Simone, it's balancing her striving for independence, but also her kind of evolution of what being loyal means.
Well, I don't actually have the money on me. I just come by to say, you know, I'll have it soon.
So you came by to not pay my uncle. Every character's going through a lot. And so it's sort of like a domino effect. The tiles are kind of tipping.
I'm torn between becoming part of the family business that we're in and torn between my father's wishes and what I want for myself.
The loyalties aren't what he thinks they are. Family isn't what he thinks it is.
It's always fun to explore family dynamics because it's so universal, and to do it within the context of a crime story and a larger story, I think that is the dynamic of seeing a family business where everybody loves each other have to take on something where people don't care about each other. It's a different mindset.